Okay, I have opened Google Earth Pro, and I am going to zoom into the subject property. You can always put the address up here. And this is the garden bed that I want to measure. Let's zoom in a little closer. And I always want to reset the tilt and compass. And what I'm doing is I'm just rolling the ball on my mouse to zoom in. And I'm going to reset. I'm going to go to view, reset, tilt, and compass every single time I roll in or out before I'm going to take a measurement, because it will throw all of my measurements off. So I'm going to go grab this polygon and I'm going to create a brand new measurement. I'm just putting dots all along the edge. So it's basically connect the dots. And the more dots I put on here, I'll be able to smooth it out. Okay, so I'm just quickly doing this. Okay. And I know I can pull these out. See right here, I can pull these out or in. Every one of these dots, I can pull them out and I can make it smoother. But what I really want is to be able to see what is underneath all of this, because I can see I didn't follow the lines real exactly. So I know that's part of it. But what I'm going to do, so this little box popped up on another screen. I have multiple monitors. I'm going to title this. This is where I have all of my plum trees. There's some pomegranate trees, some cherry trees, some pear trees, and some other things. So I'm just going to call this plum, pom, pear, and cherry guild. This is an establishment guild I have to build a food forest. Okay, then I'm going to go into style and color. I don't really care about this top one. This one is the line. So if I want this to be another color, let's just say red, I can change the color to red. And you can't really see it very well, so I'm going to change that to 10 and you can see it better. But I don't like a thick line like that, so I'm just going to call it, I'm just going to say 1. But this interior part is, I'm gonna make that this teal color. You can make it any color you want. You can either make it one of these colors or you can choose the rainbow. You can pick another color, or you can put your HTML colors in here as well. But we're gonna do that, but I still can't see through it. So I'm gonna change the opacity. Right now it's at 100%. I'm gonna change it to 50. So now I can see under here. And since I clicked okay, it went, my little box went away. So I'm going to right click on this, or, and see this little check mark here, or I can right click on this and click properties, or I can right click on this and click properties. Okay, so here's style and color. Here's longitude and latitude and some other things. Here's altitude. And I want to see the measurement. So right now it's in miles. You can do centimeters, meters, kilometers, inches, feet, yards, but you can, and whatever this smoots is, I'm not really sure what that is, but I want it to be in feet. And then that's for the perimeter, and I want the area to be in square feet. So now I have my measurement of how many square feet I have in here, but I can also see that that's not as smooth. It's not following the line. I can do some tweaking here or there. But so this gives me the square feet. So I'm going to just click OK. That was, it's saying 2155 square feet. This is also showing the perimeter. So that would be the outside line. Well, why would I want to know that? Well, I don't know. Maybe I want to put a fence around it, or maybe I want to put some soaker hoses or something in there. But for whatever reason, if I want to put rocks or bricks or something around here, which I don't, but I have that measurement and it's showing me 319 feet, linear feet. And then this one is showing the interior. So can you imagine trying to get measurements on, you know, all of these wavy lines, and by yourself, it's just almost impossible. You got to have somebody holding the other end, right? So I'm going to click on OK, and I'm going to zoom out again, and I'm going to click back on some of these. You can start to see them popping up that I've already done. Okay. So these are all of my little garden beds, and what I have done, this is just kind of a spreadsheet that I keep for, let me just make this a little bit bigger. And I went in, this is a spreadsheet that I keep on a lot of different things, like my fumigant plants, my pests and predators, my wish list, my seed inventory. But I'm going to title this Garden Measurements, because I don't want to know. I wanted to know how, first of all, I wanted to know how many square feet do I have of garden space. I've been wanting to know that for about 3 years, and now I know. Approximately now I know. If I put this in Excel, then it auto sums for me, and I also have it broken down by bed. So I have about 7,000 square feet that I've measured so far. But I also want to know, let's zoom in here. When I'm designing my plants placement and where I want to put stuff, let me reset tilt and compass. I can see that went off again. Now I have how much, because I can see where the plum trees are, I want to know how much space I have just in this one little area right here. I've already done this also for the pomegranates. This is where I have my pomegranates. This is where I have my cherries. This is where I have my pear trees. This is where my grapes are. This is where my, this is my oak guild. I plant a lot of stuff in there as well. So now what I can do is I can go grab this. I can print to a PDF, and I have a legend here of everything that I want to do. I can retitle this map. Let's just say I zoom in even more. And now I can just do my designing just for this one area right here. Or if I want to zoom out, I can catch everything, which that's too much information for me. So I am just going to, whoops, went out too far. Reset tilt and compass. All right, lost my place. So I'm going to go back, zoom back into my subject property here. Okay. So that's just too much information. So I'm going to take all of that back off. I just wanted to be able to show you. This is where my peach guild is. This is my Huglekultur bed. I guess I'm taking you on a little tour. This is what I call Hugel 1. This is Hugel 2. This is my little kitchen garden right off the back of my back porch. But what I want to know, let me take all of that off. Now I have the area right here that I really want to focus on. Let's just say it's the plum guild. And now what I can do, okay, let me reset tilt and compass one more time. There we go. Now I can focus just on this one area. And I know by looking at it, how many square feet do I have just in this area? I have 549 square feet, give or take a little bit. But the thing that's really cool about it, if I get back out of print mode, I can actually look at the scale down here. That's the really cool thing about it, is I can see that, and you have to reset your tilt and compass to be able to get a good accurate reading. But if I scroll in a little bit more, it'll only let me go so far before it tries to take me to street view like it did a minute ago. Let's see if I can get to 20. Okay, so now I have a scale of this much right here. Let me move this over so you can see a little bit. Well, it moves with it. I can see that this, if I took a ruler and I measured that, I would say that's probably about 4 inches, but I would take a ruler, I would measure that, and I would say, okay, every 4 inches is 20 feet. And then I can break that down and I can say half of that, every 2 inches is 10 feet. Every 1 inch is 5 feet, give or take. So, but you know, I can tell you that the survey that I got with my property is not exactly accurate either. It's pretty close. That is the information that I wanted today in order to be able to plan out my plum guild. Or I can do the same thing on, say, this apple guild right here. These are where I have my apple trees. So let's just click on that. There's my apple guild right there. If I were to make this a little bit more transparent and I can see through there a little bit more, let's say I'll make it 20% instead, then I can see there's an apple tree, there's an apple tree, there's an apple tree right there, and all of this stuff in between, because I can just walk out my front porch and see what's going on here. I know that this is some horseradish and some salvia. This is the strawberry patch. This is some 4 o'clocks and zinnias and an iris patch. But now I can take this information and how many square feet. Let's just look at that. That's about 580 square feet that I have to plant into. And that is the information I needed. So on to the next step.